Well, first off, thank you for coming today. My name is Dave Heilmann, North High Class of 74. And this is Mike Cozy, who's also North High Class of 74. A little bit about how this thing even got started. A classmate of mine emailed me a year ago, Kenny Ward, and Kenny asked me if I knew where a teacher named Pam Hansen was and why he wanted to reach her, I don't know. And I called Mr. Darnborough. Mr. Darnborough said, I don't know where she is. Get a hold of Mrs. Drenning. She kind of keeps an address list of where teachers are. I called Mrs. Drenning, and she didn't know where Mrs. Hansen was either, but we got talking about North High School, which is easy to do if we went to North and taught it. And we were reminiscing about the good old days of North, and one thing that we kind of both came to the same conclusion is that there's a lot of history at North High, and as we're all aging and losing teachers and students, a lot of that history's going with it. So Mrs. Drenning was lamenting a bit about one of the teachers had passed away not too long before I talked to Ms. Drenning, and I said, well, you know, we made a DVD for our class of 74 for our 30th reunion, and I said, you know, maybe it's an idea that we could make a DVD kind of about North, and in particular to honor the teachers at North, and that's how this idea came about. So you can blame Mrs. Drenning. So I got a hold of Mike, and Mike lives in Birmingham, Alabama now. He left Columbus right after graduating in 74, and he has a video business, does weddings and various things. And he did our 1974 DVD, and I'm sure Mike regrets now ever agreeing to this. I had the easy job of just kind of filming things, and I don't know how to take film. I mean, if you put on a tripod and keep it still, you kind of get it right. So Mike kind of came up with the idea of what would go in the DVD, and it kind of changed as we went along. But I did the easy work. I did maybe 2% of the work. He did 98% of the work. So Mike Cozy, I would like you to give Mike a hand. We talked a lot on the phone, emailed back constantly, you know, and I'd send him kind of some raw footage down, and it's amazing what he can do with poorly filmed things and make them turn out well, the magic of editing and all that. So, do you want to say anything?
Yeah,
Mike?
I do, actually. I'll say that. If you did not get a copy of the DVD, make sure that you're out there, make sure you pick one up. We make money, and of course, I put them in a box and taped it up. I used about 4 pounds of tape to send them up here. Now, understand, I got the phone call from Dave in a year ago, November of 2007. And I worked on this. I'm up at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning sometimes putting this thing together. These were my babies. I sent them up here to him. He gets me on the phone. The box was crushed, and they're all missing.
Well, they weren't. If he could have come through the phone, I wouldn't be standing here. It was dead silence. And I let him stew for about 20 seconds. I said, I got to tell him. You know, they came perfectly packaged and all of that. So.
Well, this thing started out to be about a 30-minute history lesson. If we were going to show you the entire thing, it would be about 2 hours. This thing, it comes with two scene selections. This is one. When you play it home, you see it. And there's a third one. There's a bonus section that has some of the stuff from our class of 74. And I did one for the class of 75. And there were a few interviews in there that we put in. And that's the bonus section. So if you guys want to watch it. Now there was, on the bonus section, the one that I entitled Beauty and the Beast. And that was the one with the interview between Mr. Darnborough and Mr. Baker. So now, the question that I have
73 or 74, I can't remember which.
At that time, you were older than me. What happened?
So long when I passed you up. But anyhow, this thing was, to say the least, a labor of love between both of us. I mean, we sweated over this thing, and there was stuff that we cut out that I had no more room to put it. So that really was brokenhearted. It was so interesting. Well, I wish that I knew the history of this school when I was here, when I was there. I probably would study. But I had more fun doing this thing, and the lost sleep was well worth it. I cut my first piece of film at North High School. They had a creative filmmaking course, Mr. Sherman. I got a war story to tell you about that, but I can't do it in this company. I caught the bug there, and there's something about that school that you folks made it something. I have not seen anything like this. I've been all over the country, and I do training videos, I do documentaries, I do weddings, divorces, and honeymoons, all that stuff. But I have not seen anything that has the camaraderie, the loyalty that this school has. So my applause to us.
Yes. So we'll go ahead and start the DVD, and it, as Mike said, when you first put the DVD in, you can select whether to play it beginning to end, which beginning to end, it's about 2 hours. Today, we're not going to show every section, otherwise we'll be here for 2 hours plus. But we're basically going to show the ones where, like the marching band, it's just old movies of the marching band and some taped music of the marching band too. There's no dialogue in it.
What years?
Those are in the 70s.
74.
74, probably.
I was in it in the 30s.
Did they do Script North? Somebody told me that North Band used to do Script North.
Jim McCreary was our drum major. He was the first drum
Dr.
major to spin the baton over the goalpost at a high speed.
Yeah.
Because he lived on Weber, he walked down Calumet North, and he would practice spinning it over the wires as he went down.
Mom, did we live in McCreary's old house? The house on Weber was Dr. McCreary's old house.
Dr. Idling came out. My husband sat down with him and said, I don't think you need to take these homes down. You ought to go up to it.
Dr. McCreary's childhood home.
But it was Dr. McCreary's home. Yeah.
Tom Dale said that the first year he was the band director there, they had big posters of N-O-R-T-H. And he says that they practiced it perfectly and their kids marched it perfectly, but he didn't plan it perfectly because they did it exactly right, and when they came up with the letters all came together from across the field and spelled N-R-O-T-H.
We're going to do our show just selected pieces of this today. Instead of all of it. And we'll start just with the first piece, which is something called The Mission. Okay. And this, The Mission is just kind of a opening that Mike came up with. It's kind of cute.
The acting sucks.
Yeah, the acting's bad. But I'm bad. June
is Thursdays, or whatever June it is.
So I showed up and took some film, and that's how that ended up in there. So next is a short piece called Through the Years, and then we'll do the memorial and credits there at the end. So go ahead, Mike.
Segments are going to run together. One is the memorial of the folks that we lost, and the very last is the credits. The credits run about an hour and a half. Like we said at the beginning, Dave and I did most of the work with him, but we couldn't have done squat had been you folks. I tried to put everybody's name in it that even that much to do with it. If I've missed anybody, I apologize. But I'm just
that stuff, isn't it? I did have a little bit of fun with the credits. So make sure you read all of
them. There'll be a quiz afterwards.
I did take a jab or two at West.
Did you hear what Dave was saying? She went to Nora?
Thank you.
that's all we're going to show today. And again, thank you for coming. And all the teachers, please grab a copy of that DVD. The pieces, there's something called extras. And then there's a piece that was filmed, I think, for the 75 class for their 30th reunion. And Mr. Harker is, I think he sings with his ukulele in it. Is that right, Mike?
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you haven't seen Ukulele Man sing, you get your chance there. There's an interview with Mr. Scott. There's an interview with Mr. Darmbro, Ms. Hoffaker, Radigay, is that the right
name?
Radigay. And then there's an interview with Mr. Dale and Mr. Spivey that was also done for that class of 75 DVD. And then there's a couple other pieces in there too. So the last thing I want to say is it was a lot of fun doing this. And as I get older, I appreciate North more and more. The intent was to thank our teachers for what they did for us. And I know when I went to Ohio State, when I was a freshman at Ohio State, and I was scared about going to college and all that, I was so well prepared when I went there. I got a 4.0, I think, my first year. All the math I took at Ohio State, I already had in high school, thanks to Mr. Rice. I was competing against kids from Arlington, Bexley, Columbus Academy, Columbus School for Girls. Every academic, high academic school around, I competed against. And I was better prepared, thanks to the teachers that I had in the class. So, thank you.
Before you get up and leave, make sure that you grab a DVD. If you don't already have one, Dave said for $5 he'd autograph it for you. I just want to thank each and every one of you. I didn't have all of you in class. You're probably happy about that. I pretty much was lousy in math. You know, I bought a new car when I left North, when I went down to Alabama in about 3 months ago. Thank you.
We want to thank you.
I checked and double checked and kind of triple checked, but I'm sure self checked. It was fun. It was a lot of work. Thank you, Mike. You did all the hard work, and appreciate you so much coming today. And hopefully, it means a little something to you to take a piece of North High. And you know, as I was watching it back there in the back, kind of in this setting, I hope you know we had a great high school to celebrate. So let's not leave here down about North closing. You know, it's done, but they can't take the memories that we have of that high school. And not as a student, not as a teacher, and it will never be duplicated. I don't think that was a special place. And we're all just blessed that we were part of that. Yes, Mr. Allen.
Yeah, Dave, where can we get additional copies, with whom and how much?
Get a hold of me, and they're $300 a piece for you. No, just get a hold of me. Actually, I have a form back there that has my address on it, and I'll write my telephone number. And I thought I'd just give one to Skip to keep up there at Yogi's.
All right,
there's a lot more people going.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
I thought I'd let you know there are 27 polar bear graduates living here at Westwood Glen.
27?
And there are two or three teachers, Gene Luddy and
Betty Eastwood.
Okay.
And at least one or two more.
Mr. Murray back here graduated in 1928 from North.
Yeah.
What year did you?
31.
31. And there was another woman here from graduated in 31. She, no. She's sitting there behind this fish. So.
1946.
46.
49.
36. You're 39.
Class of 39. Did you know a teacher named John Trace by chance?
No.
John Trace Miss Strinning had an address for him. He lives in Arizona. He's 98 years old. He taught at North from 38 to 41, and he sent me a letter, which I had Mike read. If anybody wants to read the letter, I have it with me. And he sent his picture, and I'm not kidding you. He's 90. He's in that picture. He's 97. And he looks like he's about 65.
It's not unusual for people to be 100. You've got two that are 98, one, two abandoned, one of them, maybe a couple more than one of them. You're 100 or over, and 96. I'm 95, and on down the line to Al. Al is 98.
John Trace, when he left North, as an educator, you might be interested in what he went and did, but he basically went to work for the U.S. government and established schools all around the world. He helped establish public school systems in many third world nations, and this was done in the 40s and 50s, and that's what he ended up doing his whole career. Any other questions? Okay, grab a DVD on your way out, teachers, and thanks for coming again.
to North.
Oh, yes. Hit my hero very much, though. Yeah. She did not hit my hero very much, though. I was there in the 40s. That little quality show, though. That was worth coming to see.
It's fun, though, just working.